Welcome to our Thursday Movie Night. We love the TV series called The Chosen. If you've missed any of the previous episodes, go to thechosen.tv tomorrow and watch them. Or better yet, download the free app and you'll not only be able to watch all the episodes, you'll even be able to cast it to your smart TV. For those of you watching this introduction after Thursday's premiere, you will need to go to the web or the app to watch this episode. It's our hope that this little introduction we give each week will give you a little bit of a boost so that you can better enjoy the series. First, a segment we call In the Scriptures. There are two main passages that this episode will flesh out for us. There is first the Moses and the bronze serpent. The story is found in Numbers 21, verses 4 through 9. The Israelites are growing weary of wandering in the wilderness like they usually do, and they start complaining. So God sends fiery serpents to bite the people, and many are growing sick and dying. When Moses asks God how to handle the problem, God commands Moses to make a serpent out of bronze, put it on a pole, and if someone is bit by a snake and they make the choice to look up at the bronze serpent, they will live. There's a reason this episode starts with this event. See if you can make the connection as to why. And then there's Nicodemus meeting Jesus. This is the famous story found in John chapter 3, verses 1 through 21. Remember that verse, John 3:16? Yeah, we're there. The meeting takes place at night. Perhaps it's at night to respect Nicodemus's position. Perhaps it's to protect Jesus. Some of us like to joke and we call this Nick at Night. But just a quick word about how this meeting is handled in the episode. The writers of the episode have Jesus inviting Nicodemus to follow him, which John does not record in his gospel. The writers have suggested that Nicodemus may not have become a serious believer and only followed Jesus from a distance. I believe Nicodemus became a believer because of how he is portrayed later in the gospel. In John's gospel, he will defend Jesus before the Sanhedrin in John 7, verse 50. And after Jesus is crucified, Nicodemus works with Joseph of Arimathea to take the body of Jesus, to bury the body of Jesus. And we find that in John chapter 19, verse 39. And we've seen in the book of Acts that there were indeed a contingent of believers in the early church in Jerusalem who were Pharisees just like Nicodemus. As with the previous episode, some of this episode will introduce things with which we have no record of Jesus or the disciples saying or doing. But the principles that are being laid out are generally very consistent with the character of Jesus as well as the cultural background of how people lived in the first century. And as the producers of The Chosen will encourage you, make sure you are reading your Bible and especially the Gospels for the best information. Now, for a section we call Terms and Practices. Ema, again, means mother. Abba means father. Let me talk about a snake on a pole, not to be confused with snakes on a plane. But when you see Moses making a serpent of bronze and putting it on a pole, you might start wondering about the imagery here. There are two different versions of this image found in secular history. One is called the caduceus. It's sometimes mistakenly associated with medicine. It has two snakes intertwined on a staff with a pair of wings on the top. It's a very, very old symbol dating back to 4000 BC or so, long before Moses. And it was thought to be the staff of the god Hermes. And so it's really more accurately associated with logistics, as in think UPS, since Hermes was the messenger god who flew on winged sandals. And the other image is called the rod of Asclepius. This is connected to the Greek god Asclepius, a deity associated with healing and medicine. And this symbol has a single rod with a single snake. It seems that this one dates back to about 400 BC, which is about 1,000 years after Moses. Some have suggested that the Greeks stole this image from the story of Moses and the bronze serpent. Let me say a word about Meribah. Moses will mention this briefly. It's the story of the Israelites complaining again about, this time about the lack of water in the wilderness. And God tells Moses to strike the rock and water comes out. And this story can be found in Exodus 17. The word Adonai is Hebrew for Lord. Circumcision for newborn boys was typically done on the eighth day after birth. This was also when the child was given a name, and another term for the ceremony of circumcision is bris. Mezuzah. Mezuzah is a small piece of pottery, and on the inside, or stone, and on the inside is a piece of parchment with the Shema written on it. Remember the Shema back from episode 3? That's Hear, O Israel, the Lord your God is one. You shall love the Lord your God, and on and on. And this piece of pottery is usually nailed to the doorpost of a Jewish house. And the practice comes from Deuteronomy 6, verse 9, which says, you shall write God's commandments on the doorposts of your house and on your gates. And throughout this and following episodes, watch for a Jewish character passing through a doorway. You'll see them touch the mezuzah. Sometimes they kiss their finger first and then touch the mezuzah. Lastly, a section we refer to as characters. We hope you're getting familiar with the main characters, but here's just a quick refresher. Matthew was a Jewish man working as a tax collector for the Romans. And I hope you've paid attention to just how much tax collectors were hated by everyone, even including his own family. Simon Peter, there's Simon and his family. He has a wife named Eden and a brother named Andrew. And his mother-in-law is very, very sick. Nicodemus, again, he's the Pharisee who's trying to figure out how Mary Magdalene was delivered from her demons. He seems to have a sincere heart to know God, and he is married to Zohara. And there's the Romans. Quintus is the head government official, and Gaius is Matthew's bodyguard. And then, of course, there's Mary Magdalene. She's one of Jesus's earlier followers, having had 7 demons cast out of her by Jesus. We encourage you to find out more about The Chosen. Open your browser and go to thechosen.tv on the web or download the free app on your mobile device. You'll be able to watch the episodes over and over from there. We also encourage you to give your financial support to this project. We do. We'd also like to encourage you to think about hosting a watch party each week. Even if you've already seen each episode, we're finding it so much more fun and edifying to watch with others. At the end of the episode, be sure to head back to the Calvary Fullerton YouTube channel to watch the live broadcast as we discuss what we will have just watched. We'll start as the credits are rolling. If you have any questions or comments you'd like to share during the post-episode discussion, just text the church office at 714-879-3314. We'll do our best to address as many of the comments as we can. And as per our agreement with The Chosen, our YouTube presentation of the episode will only be up for the live premiere. After that, if you want to rewatch the episode itself, you will need to go to The Chosen website or use their app. Now hold on tight, because here we go.